Stories are so powerful. It leaves a great impact on human mind. You must have heard many stories in your childhood you can still remember. So if you are in business, it is very important for you to understand or to learn the art of story. Have you ever thought that how does some people get too many difficulties in the life but still they progresses? Where there may be many people who got small difficulties and they simply give up. There is a difference between the people who get success and who gets the failure. The people or the person who gets success, he tried 10 times, he failed 10 times, but on the 11th time, he gets the success. But the person who gets the failure, he tries 5 times and he gave up. So today I am going to share a story about the founder of Honda Automobile Corporation, Mr. Soichiro Honda. Mr. Soichiro Honda was born in a small family, middle class family. He was not born with a golden spoon in his mouth. He went to the engineering school and there he prepared a prototype of piston rings. He went to Toyota and presented his prototype of piston rings. But Toyota simply rejected it. And after that, he became the center of laugh among his colleagues and friends. But he was inspired. He thought, if they are laughing, let them laugh. He worked again and this time he created a new prototype and he presented the same prototype to Toyota, and this time he got selected. Toyota extended him financial help to set up the factory, and once the factory was ready and it was about to launch, there was an earthquake in Japan. His factory got destroyed completely. But he thought, never mind, everything is good. We will rebuild it again. He started building his factory again. But at this time, Japan has entered into the World War. And there was a shortage of cement supply. But still, he was inspired. He thought he will find some way, and he found a way to create cement. And he started building his factory again. By the time his factory has built, America has entered into the World War. And America started bombarding all over the Japan, and his factory got bombarded. His factory got destroyed again. But still at this time, he was inspired, he was unstoppable. He thought, it's fine, never mind, I'll make my factory again. So during the World War, they used to have a plane where they have a gasoline tank. Once the fuel is over, they used to drop the gasoline tank on the ground. He started collecting those and he started building the factory out of it. And he built his factory again. But this time, Japan has lost the World War. And there was a shortage of fuel supply. People did not have fuel. how they can run a car, how can they drive a car. If there is no demand of car, why Toyota will manufacture the car? And if there is no manufacturing, there is no order for the piston rings. He has built the factory, he has everything set up, but there was no order. Now what to do? Any person with a normal mindset might have given up too early. But he had the inspiration. He never gave up. At that time, he used to ride a bicycle. One day he got an idea in his mind and he set up one motor in his bicycle. And that was the first prototype of motorcycle. He used to drive that motorcycle around his surroundings. And people saw that. People saw that and they say, can you make it for me? He built such 20 bicycles, or you can say motorcycles. After that, he realized that he has got an idea which he can market. But he did not have the money. But again, he was inspired. He was unstoppable. He had the idea. He had the courage. He started approaching all the bicycle stockists in the Japan. He found 8,000 of them. And he has sent letter, handwritten letter to 5,000 such bicycle stockists seeking for the help. And out of those 5,000, 1,800 replied. And they extended their small help to set up the factory. By that help, Mr. Soichiro Honda started a factory. And he has created a prototype of his motorcycle. But that was too big. And his first version of motorcycle was a failure. But again, he had an inspiration. He was inspired within himself. He started rebuilding it again. And he has created a second design. And this time, it was an immediate success. And after that, he never looked back. And during his time, Honda Corporation employed more than 100,000 employees. And now it has more than 200,000 employees. So guys, success you will find if you are inspired. If you had that enthusiasm in it, in you, you will find the success. There are three types of people. There will be some set of people, they will think, let's try. Let's try, if it works, then fine. If it doesn't work, then it is fine. There will be second type of people who will be kind of middle group. I like thinking of like a middleman. They will say, if there is something, let's try. And they do it, they put some efforts. But there will be people who will be called superior. And they think, if there is something, we should try and we should give our best shot. There is no look back option for them. There is no chance of failure. Such people, if they get difficulties on their path, they will surmount it, they will surpass it, because they have that inspiration. But the people who does not have, or who do not have that mindset, even a small difficulties will become like a mountain for them. So guys, think about yourself, think about your personal life, think about your professional life, or think about your business. What kind of difficulties you are facing? Work towards that. Work like the way there is no other option. Right? Be a better version of yourself. Work for yourself every day. Even if you get better 1% every day, over the time, you will be very close to your success. So guys, this is the story I wanted to share today. I hope you got the inspiration from it. I wish you all the best for your success, and I'll see you in another set of story. Till then, take care and keep growing.